Over the next two decades, inter and intra-city transport will undergo a material transformation with a forecast fivefold increase in high-speed rail track, a global electric vehicle market that UBS forecasts to exceed $1 trillion by 2026, with European and Chinese consumers the most positive on EVs, followed by the US and Japan. And a $1.5 billion opportunity in last-mile solutions. From micro-mobility to the potential of electric-powered flight. But what is driving this? Transport is out of step with net-zero ambitions, contributing an estimated 16% of global greenhouse gas emissions. The cost of carbon is also rising, and fast. Low-carbon transport is now a political priority around the world. China's pledge to go carbon neutral by 2060 will involve greener transportation, and pressure to find greener solutions will grow. We think gravitation towards cities will continue in a post-pandemic world, even if partly to secondary cities. This will likely mean increased pressure and congestion on local mass transportation and a need for innovation. But the ability to work from home has also led to people leaving big cities. In New York City, more than 21,000 people on average initially left every month since the COVID-19 pandemic hit in early 2020. Traveler demographics are also key drivers for change. In general, younger generations are less likely to own a car than older generations. Today, travelers are more open to the idea of using emerging modes of transport, such as sky taxis, electric and hybrid planes, and self-driving vehicles. There will be a need for infrastructure to house new and existing forms of transportation. We believe any reduced tax base will spur authorities to seek public-private partnerships in transport systems, and the innovation in transportation will mostly be driven by private sector funding. So where do the roadblocks lie? Costs will be a factor in this new data-driven transportation. For instance, a Hyperloop link between Los Angeles and San Francisco could cost between $50 million and $150 million per kilometer. Another issue centers on government policy and regulation. Amid challenging economic times, public funds are limited and spending on transport infrastructure will remain targeted. Governments also have to carry out thorough testing and health and safety checks on new technologies before they can be used in public transport. So timeframes are uncertain. But we believe the pressures mounting in favor of new inter and intra-city transport solutions spell compelling investment opportunities. And that makes the sector well worth a trip.